is the real key to getting stacked, jacked, yoked, or swole simply a matter of lifting heavy ass weights on the reg? Or for those of you out there just trying to get big as fuck, is it a complete waste of time? That's exactly what we're going to discuss in today's Flex Friday workout. What's up, meatheads? Coach Mandler here, Team Swole Patrol. Got a kick-ass Flex Friday workout for you. But before we get to that, I want to answer the question that I just talked about. Whether or not the key to getting jacked is simply a matter of lifting heavy-ass weights. You see and hear about so many guys out there talking about how the testosterone fairies will come and visit you at night if you simply lift heavy all the time. Just nothing but lift heavy ass weights. Well, there are shades of truth to that and shades of bullshit. Here's the simple truth in regards to whether or not lifting heavy, which is I'd say anything at or above 80% of your one rep max, and whatever squat, deadlift, bench press, or overhead press variation you're going to be doing for your core lift, is the key to you getting more jacked, building more muscle mass. Yes, your body will respond by producing and releasing more testosterone into your bloodstream, but no, it's not going to help as much as if you match it up with more time under tension work that you follow up with that heavy core lift. So what I do is, very simply put, whenever I do cycle in more heavy work, anywhere from a 1 to a 5 rep max on my core lift, I always follow that up with a weak point specific accessory exercise that I do with high volume, probably in the 10 to 20 rep range. Doing that together, lifting heavy in the core lift, followed by high volume work and the specific weak points that's keeping me from being able to lift heavier with my core lift, is the key to building more of that functional and athletic muscle that allows me to look and perform like an absolute ass-kicking machine. The other thing I want you to think about too is you will start to see diminishing returns if you continue to lift at or above probably 85 or 90% of your existing one rep max. Why is that? Because it's simply too demanding on your nervous system, and overall, you're going to start to see kind of some of the symptoms of overtraining that we've talked about before. So simply put, yes, lifting heavy in your core lift can build more mass, but make sure you don't lift heavy all the time, and make sure that whenever you do lift heavy, you follow that up with some multi-joint weak point exercises that are gonna be higher in volume than the heavy work that you just did with your core lift. Hopefully that makes sense. If you have any questions in regards to this or anything else that will help you perform and look like an absolute savage, simply leave that in the comment section below, and I'll be happy to hook you up with a response either down below or in a future video. Now, let's get to the good shit. In today's Flex Friday workout, we're going heavy as shit on the bench and going high volume, hypertrophy with our shoulders, our back, and our pipes. So without further ado, let's get started on today's Flex Friday workout.
We'll be right back.
thanks for checking out today's video. If you dig what you saw and want to see more of the same tips and routines delivered Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, do me a solid, do yourself a solid by hitting the like button, subscribing by tapping on my ugly mug down below, and be sure to pick up your free copy of the muscle building blueprint that I put together for you by clicking on that button right there. Appreciate your time, guys. Have a good one. Mandler out.